Kuchipudi. History tells us that in Andhra Pradesh, dance flourished among Devadasis, also called as temple dancers. Due to a decline in their status, dance was gradually discredited. Thus, it became necessary for men to learn the art. Legends tells us that this dance got a new life in the hands of male Brahmins whose guiding light was Siddhendra Yogi. These Brahmins propagated the dance with the principal idea of devotion to their supreme Godhead. Generations of these Brahmins have propagated this dance from their village of Kuchipudi, giving the dance form its name. Vijayawada is on the banks of river Krishna and it is also the gateway to the village Kuchipudi. Under the watchful eyes of the presiding deity of Kuchipudi, young boys rise at dawn and begin their daily training. They do yogasanas and mandatory push-ups for their spine flexibility. Gurus expect complete devotion and dedication from his students. Watching the young ones go through their dance practice, one is reminded of the lineage of great teachers, successive heritage of whom, who have handed their dance heritage to the little ones of today. During the time of Vendantam Lakshmi Narayana Shastry, one of the great exponents of this dance tradition, the idea of having separate items flourished. Earlier, a full-length presentation of a dance drama was performed where all the items from beginning to end were interconnected. In 1932, Ragini Devi went to Vijayawada and saw Kuchipudi performance and she was so taken up with Dashavataram. She decided to learn it from a Kuchipudi guru and she taught this to her daughter Indrani. Excerpts of the dance was always taken and were presented as solo items. Once they started, it became like women entering into the tradition and all male tradition was being broken up and more women were taking to it.
Takita takam, takita jam, takita takam, takita jam, takita jam, takita takam.
The male exponents of Stree Vesham, female impersonation, was practiced in the early years of revival of dance by male Brahmin dancers and is followed even today. When a male dancer is interpreting a feminine role or a female dancer performing a male is something very beautiful by getting into the skin of that gender and understanding their beauty. Later, this got paired up between husband and wife. When the husband and wife team come in, then it's always the male role for the male and the female role for the female. Then it completely became gender-oriented presentation. When all male traditions became more female traditions, there are changes that takes place and Kuchipudi developed the way it did because earlier it was done essentially by males. What made Kuchipudi? How was Bharatanatyam to be compared with Kuchipudi? In Kuchipudi, there are circular movements, diagonal stretches, linear arm stretches, agile leaping movements, gravity-bound footsteps, contrast with undulating body movements. Great poet Kshetraya wrote his poems of love which is to be expressed in the dance and it is called as Abhinaya. Tata dim tam tata dim tata dim tam tata dim 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 tata d
tatadim tam tatadim tatadim dim tatadim tatadim tam tatadim tatadim dim tatadim tatadim
The Yakshagana theatre tradition says that every actor of Kuchipudi must sing and enact the character being played.
సుదర్శనాయుడు కనపడక ఉండే నిన్ను ఈ సామంతులెల్లరూ దుష్టంగా ఉందని నిందించి ఈసరింప అతనిఘాతం పద్మా కదాఘాతం చే నీ శిరంబు సహస్ర శిఖరంబులుగా వచ్చిన చూపించదవా నిశ్చయముగా
One of the very famous folk dances, Pagati Vesham, among many other colorful and interesting traditions. Many of these dances take common themes as their main subjects, as does Kuchipudi. Headgear, Bhama kalapam and Ganiyam, the very famous wooden-made theatre ornaments, are not to be seen anymore today. Today's students, caught amidst various diversions, has little time for following the traditional system of learning. Use of modern methods for revising their lessons, for learning new items, or of teaching new dance items, as well as performing to taped music have become common features now. The students of any classical dance should be in a position to choreograph and adapt to the things whenever there is necessary. Now, the dances are choreographed for the medieval Telugu poems for the students. In solo Kuchipudi, there is a peculiar way of making it so Lasya oriented. The male doing the female role in the past was already exaggerating, and now even more as it is the woman who is doing the Lasya movements. She makes it even more feminine oriented. Nowadays, there are more embroideries taking place in dance, which is more decorative and very pleasing in styles. But the quality of stillness in depth and the serenity of the style is not to be found too much today.
Oh my God.